What is going on, everyone? This is your boy ACK here. We are here with another Spotlight Series interview. Every week we have a new artist. Week or two ago we had Connor McAllister from Ireland, and we're kind of going back over there and we're talking about Kelan Browne. Kelan, how are you today, dude?
Oh, I'm all good. Thanks for having me on the show.
No, of course. I appreciate you coming on. Kind of when I was doing Connor's interview, we were talking a little bit about you. I started listening to some of your covers and your song that you have out now. Just some really cool stuff that you're doing. For people that don't know who you are, if you don't mind just kind of telling us a little bit about yourself.
Yeah, my name's Kelan Browne. I'm 18 years of age and I'm from Donegal in Ireland, of course. And I'm just across the water from you. Mm-hmm. And I'm a country music singer. I think what makes me is that I sing real country music. Mm-hmm. But I don't think people here usually, the country music that's sang here is kind of different to what I actually sing. Mm-hmm. So I sing American country music because it's the real storytelling and stuff, and that's why I like to say that I'm country music compared to what country music actually is here, if you get me, if that makes sense.
No, exactly. No, and it's super cool because especially like in a lot of your covers and the song that you have out that we're going to be listening to later on in the interview, you can hear like that old style country, and that's like what I grew up on. It's kind of like that. Obviously like Ireland probably has like that different form of country like you were talking about, but like around here you kind of embody like what like the 90s like 2000 country around here is, which is like really cool just because that's what country is like starting to try to get back to a little bit.
Yeah, no.
So with that being said, like kind of how did music all start for you? Like when did you start singing? Like obviously was it at an you're only 18, was it at like an earlier age than 18, and like just how did all that come about for you?
Country music's been in my family for generations, really. My granddad was in a band and he toured about the country for many years, and my mom, she picked that up. My dad, actually, he still sings out in the local bars and stuff like that there, and he's country music as well. So, I think it was a given, like, you're a country music singer, like, and that's it. Like, I just took it off them, and, listening to, the different types of country growing up, like Alan Jackson from dad's side, and even going back years and years ago, like, Vernon Oxford, Merle Haggard, George Jones, that was my grandma stuff, and now I'm kind of grown up with more country pop.
Yeah,
which is good in its own way, but it's not my kind of country. Do you get?
No, exactly. And I totally get that. I can't remember who I was having this conversation with, because it was in my interview with Kate Reed. We were talking about like kind of like where country's at right now, because I think it was back, I'm horrible with my dates, I think it was 2011, I want to say, but I could be wrong with that. When Florida Georgia Line came out with Cruise, that just kind of like took country in like 25 million different directions, because they kind of started getting into some more stuff, and then Jason Aldean kind of switched up from what he was originally doing to kind of going more like southern rock country and stuff like that. And but it's just cool now because like some of these other artists, like big name artists, is like Morgan Wallen, Luke Combs, and like a lot of them are trying to go back to that older style country, like from like what you said, like Alan Jackson, George Jones, George Strait, Travis Tritt, one of my favorites, and just stuff like that. So obviously you kind of like mentioned some of those country artists that like probably inspire you and stuff like that. Would you say some of like your friends and family like kind of really pushed you to start singing too as well?
Oh, yeah, of course. I mean, like, seeing my mom out, she'd be doing, different competitions and stuff. And, just the feel of, what she was singing and seeing people enjoying themselves. And, it's for some people, it's, their only thing that they have the weekend, especially because I sing the old country. Mm-hmm. I'd be doing more like dance halls and stuff like that for maybe the older generations, and you know, of course they wouldn't be going out to, you know, the football or, you know, different things on the weekend. Like maybe that's their only form of getting out anywhere. And it's great to see that I can help them enjoy themselves.
Exactly.
You know, give them something to look forward to. And, you know, that's what it's really all about, like, you know?
Yeah, no, absolutely. And then kind of like, if you want to touch up, just because like, I'm always curious about like different places and stuff like that. Like what is like, really like, kind of like, what is the music scene out there? Like, what's it like? Cause I mean, like, obviously like we have Nashville here, and I mean, obviously everyone knows about Nashville. Like that's just like, that's probably like the biggest music scene like in the United States. But, like just kind of like, what's like the music scene around like in Ireland?
I mean, there's no really set place here. Small country, you know, you can travel up and down in 6 hours. Like, I mean, you know, if you're doing a gig, you can go up and down anywhere really in one night. So there's no really set place here, but there's, you know, famous dance halls. I've just been booked in one now in the next couple of months for the very first time, and the likes of Charlie Pride's performed there, you know, which is insane. Like, and you know, of course that's massive, like, for, you know, because they're legends even in America. Like,
no, exactly.
You know, it's compared to American country is, there's, you know, it came from the mountains originally, and it was the handmade instruments that made country, with, along with the, you know, heartfelt stories. And I think here, because of the instruments that are used here, it's more like a folk kind of country.
Yep.
I feel like some of the problem here is there's too much of copying what's across the ocean,
mm-hmm.
other than being original over here. And I feel like that needs to be picked up on. And that's what I'm bringing to Irish country music. Of course, you know, I take it from Irish folk, Irish, you know, Irish, even rock, you know, like I take my music from all different genres and stuff like that and form it into the one. And, you know, it'd be exciting now in the coming years, now seeing what my music sounds like.
Mm-hmm.
And I hope with the fundamentals that I know of three chords and the truth with real country music, that's what I can bring, like. And, you know, I think that's what needs to be brought back.
No, exactly. No, and like I said, I mean, like, even when I was, I'm 24, like, even when I was a kid, like, just that old style country music is just always what I lean back towards, just because that's what I grew up on. And that's just when I write too, because obviously I'm a songwriter as well. It's just that storytelling vibe really hits me. And that's what a lot of old country was. Nowadays, like, I mean, I hate to say, like, I'm not bashing on country, because like that's a majority of what I listen to, but nowadays it's just either like they're not like telling that full story. They're just kind of like all talking about the same things, just kind of different words and different melodies and stuff like that. So with that being said, like, kind of like the storytelling vibes and like writing music and stuff, obviously you have one song out at the moment. So like, just like, you can even go in depth like about how you wrote that one, but like, how do you go about like writing a song and stuff like that?
Well, I did this is my actual, like, my first song that I've released. It's actually, I didn't write this song. This was one that, I don't know if you've ever heard of him, Conway Twitty.
Yep.
Conway Twitty's song Hello Darling, and
mm-hmm.
famous over here by a guy called Rolly Daniels.
Yep.
And a lot of people were familiar with that song before I, you know, re-brought it back out. And I feel like, of course, you know, I still write my own songs and stuff, but I feel like here especially, I think it's that I can do cover songs first to get my name out there.
Exactly.
And then be able to draw my audience into my music.
Mm-hmm.
And the loyal supporters of you will always stick with you no matter what you write, no matter what you do. Like, and, you know, of course, Hello Darling's been massive for me here. It's played and requested on the radio nonstop, and you know, it's great.
Awesome. Like, when you like first got it out there and like people started like recognizing you, like, was it just like, because when I released my first single, with my good friend Alexa. We were when I wrote that whole thing, and then my friend Phil Luna did the piano and stuff like that. But like, it was just so cool to get something out there like with our names on it, and like just be like just to go on Spotify or Apple Music or something, just like type in your name and just like have it be there. Like, just like, were you able to like process it all like when it first came out, or did it like kind of like have to take a little while to sink in?
No, I knew it because it was really the first time that I ever stepped foot into a recording studio, like a proper recording studio. And, you know, hearing my song on the radio for the first time, it was like, I got a wee bit emotional, I can't lie. But, you know, it's just the hard work and the grind that you put into it, and, you know, the hours that you do spend in the studio, and the, you know, the enjoyment, of course, it comes as well. But, you know, there is a stress level and an expectation you always put on yourself. Like, as an artist, you know that yourself. And, you know, it was great to listen to the finished product for the first time on the radio that I listen to every day, to like all my favorite country artists. And, you know, it was really, really cool. And the pride I had was like, it was immense. Like, and, you know, but I suppose if you want to be successful, you have to draw that pride in and go again and keep working, because, you know, that's just how the business is, and that's how it goes.
No, exactly. And I mean, just like the music business, I feel like just no matter like, even no matter where you are, whether you're here in the US, you're up in Canada, you're over in Ireland, like, it's just the music business is so hard because you have to get heard by the right people sometimes. And you just have to keep pushing yourself and keep getting that exposure, because then maybe eventually the right person will hear that and be like, hey, like, we like you, here's like something that we could work out as a deal and stuff like that. And it can only go up from there. And I feel like a lot of people are just kind of coming out more with music now because of obviously last year with the pandemic and stuff, COVID, not a fan of it, but it's just like, it's just, people are really trying to expose themselves more, which is just really cool. You know,
more people are getting into like what they really actually want to do. And, you know, I think a lot of people actually find it easier because of, you know, technology nowadays and stuff. And you're, you know, there is a sense of you are able to hide behind a screen rather than go out and sing in front of people. Mm-hmm. And I think, you know, that's, you know, I didn't really get out personally to sing in the bars or hotels or any dance halls before the pandemic. Mm-hmm. And started my covers on Facebook, and, you know, over the course of the last 12 months, I've managed to get myself on a TV show. I've managed to hit 34,000 followers, and I've managed to, you know, grow a name for myself. And, you know, you take real pride in that, and it just shows, if you want to do something, no matter if you're at the start about doing it, you get over it and you start to enjoy yourself, and, you know, it's a process, and it's a really enjoyable process, and, you know, it's gonna hopefully carry on for, you know, many, many more years for me to come.
No, exactly. And I mean, you're so young too, you're only 18, and like, it's just great, you already like have like a good head on your, or shoulder on your head, or whatever the saying is, I can't even speak today, but like, you just already like kind of like have like everything kind of like all planned out, and like, you, that's just like super cool, especially at like a young age, because sometimes people at that age, and like even younger, because like some like singing competitions, like I watch like American Idol and The Voice and stuff, like some of these younger contestants too, like just kind of still don't know like who they are as an artist and like their style and stuff. So it's just cool that like you kind of like have, not like you don't have everything figured, no one has everything figured out, but like you just like, you kind of like know who you are and like where you want to like go and the road you want to travel down, which is cool. So with that being said, kind of just getting into like kind of like the last like little question is, what are your goals as an artist, and like, where do you want to go with your music, and what else can we expect from you down the road?
I think every country artist has that one place in mind, as we were talking about earlier. It's Nashville. You know, no matter where you are in the world, it's Music City. And I do feel that Nashville's kind of taken away too from what it used to be, you know, as it has been, you know, it's the fastest growing city in America. And, you know, it's always going to be developing over years and years and years. And, you know, hopefully I'll get there sometime. And I think I'm going there next year as part of a guy called Robert Mazzell. He's a big country artist here.
Yep.
And he does tours and stuff over there and stuff like that. So I'll be going over, I'll be experiencing a lot of that, you know, culture, different sounds, and back, take notes of that, work on it, form my own sound over here, conquer Ireland, and then by, you know, making my way to Music City. And, you know, I've got a long, long road to go before I'm noticed anywhere else, you know, other than here. But, you know, it's a process, and, you know, I've got a plan in my head, and a very wise woman, my mum, she told me, she says, show never tell. So I'll keep my plans in my head. And of course, if people want to find out my journey and stay on this journey with me, then they're more than welcome to. And you can find me on all my social media platforms, and of course on the radio.
No, exactly. That's awesome, man. Like, obviously I can't wait to hear some originals and just hear some more music from you down the road, and just to see, like, because it's just cool, because like you said, like, you have that plan in your head, so it's just cool. Like, I'll definitely be following on that journey to see, like, where you go and what you do and stuff like that, so we can't wait for that. So getting to the end here is your song that you have out. So if you want to just kind of like give us a little in depth about it. I know we kind of like, you talked about it a little bit, but if you want to like talk about how it came about for you doing this song and stuff like that, and we'll take it away with it in a minute.
Yeah, no, of course. I seen this song. Of course, you probably know Scotty McCreary. He done it at Opry, and he covered Hello Darling on the Grand Ole Opry, standing ovation. And that's where I first really heard it from. And ever since, I've loved the song, and I wanted to try it out. It was my grandmother's 70th birthday party a couple of years back. And it was when I was just learning the song, and I wanted to try it on just a karaoke track and sing it at her birthday. And my auntie, she actually recorded it, and she posted it online. That got like 150,000 views, which was like crazy for me at the time. And I got noticed in the biggest local newspapers and stuff, were like, they were writing articles on me and stuff like that, and they wanted to share the video. And I actually got approached by Britain's Got Talent to go on their show, but I didn't feel I was ready for that, or, you know, the right thing for me at the moment. But, you know, it brought about loads of different, you know, doors for me to open. And I think now that hearing it on the radio and stuff, it's been crazy. And, you know, if anybody wants to stream it, it's on Spotify, it's on Apple Music, it's on YouTube, it's, you know, it's everywhere you want to look for it. It's Kelan Browne, Hello Darling. And I recorded it with a very good friend of mine now. He's actually, as I was saying, Robert Mazzell, his producer as well. And, you know, I'm actually in the middle of recording an album that'll be released later on this year as well. So yeah, if anybody wants to stay tuned to my story and my journey, then they're more than welcome to across all my social media platforms.
Awesome. So with that being said, let's take a listen to Hello Darling.
Hello, darling. Nice to see you. It's been a long time. To me, was it, darling?
That is such a cool song, man. Like, I love that. And I even heard it when Scotty McCreery did it too. It was funny because, like, the first time, like, I never like comparing people to other artists, but he was one of my favorite artists on The Voice, for all you Voice fans out there and stuff like that. But the minute, like, you started singing, I heard, I don't know if you've ever heard of him, Red Marlowe.
No, I've never heard of him before. I must look him up now, actually.
No, you definitely do take a look at him, because, like, the minute, like, I heard some of your vocals, like, it just kind of sounded like, and he was one of my favorites. He was a finalist on The Voice a few seasons ago. So it definitely just kind of, like, reminded me of that. And he has this really cool song. It was an original that he actually played on The Voice called I Pray. I think, like, you could definitely do, like, a cool version of that too, like, as, like, a cover and stuff, for sure, if you're ever looking for new covers. But no, just really cool that you have something out there, and just can't wait to hear more stuff from you. If you want to just let people know, like, what your handles are on, like, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok and stuff like that.
Most everything is Kelan Browne Music. There's no spaces or anything in between that. Maybe, well, you can put in a space and it doesn't matter, it'll still come up. And, you know, it's actually my Instagram handle. I changed it to Kelan Browne Music Official, because actually, like, it was crazy, because I was getting, like, a couple thousand requests and stuff, or, like, follows a day from, you know, like, fake accounts and stuff. And I had to make a different account, because it was getting that badly spammed and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
which is quite annoying. But yeah, you know, bro, mostly everything. And you can find me on TikTok, Twitter, YouTube. Facebook's my main one. I do live streams every couple of weeks and stuff as well, if anybody wants to tune in. And I should probably be doing more stuff on TikTok, seeing as how quickly it's grown. Like, it's mental. But yeah, that's where you can find me, and Spotify and Apple Music for my new single. And look forward to more singles and albums to come.
Awesome, man. And like I said, I can't wait to hear some more stuff, and just checking out your journey down the road, and just you doing some more covers and eventually getting some original music out there. Obviously, again, thank you for coming on and taking the time to do this and sharing some of your music. I appreciate it.
Yes, thanks for having me. It's thanks to everyone who tunes into the series, and it'll be good to see some new faces tuned into my live streams and into everything else.
No, exactly. And that's the way to do it, is to just kind of do some interviews and stuff like that and get noticed more by different fans and stuff like that. So it's really cool. So obviously, thank you again. And with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, that is another episode of the Spotlight series. Every Sunday at 1 p.m. Eastern time. Stay tuned for a new artist, another Sunday, another interview, and we will see you next week. Thanks for tuning in, guys.